Here's a look at the front of the package, and as well as the back, which is pretty much like the previous card, with just a bunch of warning signs instead of an actual picture. And now it's time for an old-fashioned unboxing. They still have the tape, by the way, but that doesn't make it any harder to open this up. Okay, so here you go, Jawas, accessories, two guns, two smaller guns. Now, starting with the little guy, here is from the front. See his bandolier there. From the side. From the back. From the top. From the bottom. Why not? And then here's the other guy. Front. Let's go this way. Side. Little holster. The back. The top and bottom. Here's a close-up on the head for this guy. The wrappings are pretty are really pronounced this time around, which is pretty nice. Here's a look at their bandoliers, which are a little bit different, but they're each sculpted equally as nice. The paint job, however, is just a little bit off here and there, but overall it's really good looking. Here they are with their weapons holstered. The big guy can he can holster both the bigger guns, but not the smaller ones. And the opposite is true for the little guy, who can only holster the smaller weapons. Here's a close-up of the texture that's present on both their robes. And it looks pretty nice, but it's probably not something that was sculpted by human hands, right? It was another one of these 3D printed textures. They probably input it into a computer and then just print it out. For the articulation, I'm happy to say that you got a ball joint ahead. The arms are fully articulated, and you have a waist. And I believe the hips are also like on a swivel, but that doesn't really do much with the robe here, but that's no problem. Here's a comparison with the older Jawas. They're kind of going back to the old tradition they started back in the Power of the Force 2 with the Jawa 2 packs, where they have a big one and a small one. The big one is it's sort of an orangey brown. And the smaller one is a just a sort of lighter brown. And it's pretty good, you know, it's nice to have that little variety. But I think I would kind of like to see the color more uniform. Now here's some comparison with, say, Luke Skywalker for size. So that's pretty good. Now really the only complaint about these guys is just the price, you know, but that's kind of expected. And at least you're getting two of them for that price, but you know, if you can get it for around 13, which is what I got it for, that's probably the best price you can get. In fact, I found one for, I was able to get it for $10, so I'm, you know, another one's on the way, and that's pretty nice. If you can get multiples of these guys, I think these are the ones that you want to army build. Now, as for my final assessment on these guys, this is probably everything that the Black Series should be, and should be excellent figures with excellent articulation and paint jobs. And new characters and new tooling, new sculpting. So these are really high up there as far as the quality that we have come to expect from Hasbro. But lately, have been surprised to actually get it now. Okay guys, so that's it. I've pretty much reached my review quota for the year. So, you know, maybe next time it'll be a custom or something. Okay guys, thanks for watching. I appreciate it, and I'll catch you on the next video.